3 odd minutes.
Yeah. Hello everybody, welcome to this week's podcast where I've been recording for 3 minutes and 45 seconds without having the microphone on.
Well,
and
it really sums up this year.
It just sums up this year in review and how good I thought I was doing, but I'm actually shite at everything that I do. So, to sum up everything everybody just said in the time that was quiet, Miles thought it was alright, Shelf thought it was alright, CJ thought it was alright, he cried sometimes. Mark had so much to say. I'm really annoyed that I missed it all.
We can't sum it up.
We just couldn't sum it. He's devastated that we missed all of his kind, and as one of the newest members of Turbo Tuesday, just
I choked up a little.
I'm crying right now. As everybody knows,
shut up! There's Kilgore on the screen.
Kilgore.
Oh, Kilgore!
Oh yeah, by the way,
we are playing Kilgore.
We're really soon here at Turbo Tuesdays. We're just straight up fucking playing Kilgore.
You're not grabbing Vincent. So yeah,
we're better than you.
We made, like, my uncle works at Iron Galaxy, so so we've got Kilgore.
But also my uncle works
only in training mode.
Yeah,
only
he works
training.
In the dojo.
We wanted to take him online, but Dave Lang said no.
Damn him. But that's fine, maybe next time.
If we take him online, we'll get grounded.
So anyway, we did a very quick year in review, which we won't do again, because CT really wants us to talk about how good Street Fighter Season 1 was. So Street Fighter 5 Season 1.
So Miles, what's your opinion on Street Fighter 5 Season 1?
Season 1.
Family friendly language if possible.
Do wait for that.
Oh well, gosh darn. I guess that Street Fighter 5 was
pretty
not
swell.
To my expectations, but many people liked it, so what...
We're not,
so
don't say what many people...
Ask
thought.
You. Ask
yeah,
your opinion.
We need to... Yeah. It's
don't
okay.
Pussy out with some blanket
if you want
answer.
To just shit all
people
over this...
Wake up, sheeple!
What? Titties, I thought was fucking shit and disappointing. But hey, people fucking liked it, so why not?
Still can't.
That's fine. He says it's shit, but he understands that people like it, but fuck them. Fuck them and their shitty decisions. Now, CJ, you were like the king of Ultra here. You turned up and just smashed everybody repeatedly. 5 came along, we were ready for a new game.
And you didn't even win the last Street Fighter tournament.
But that's fine, because CG's had other things to do.
Like Marvel.
But, yeah.
But Marvel.
You said Marvel.
But no,
like CG. Yeah, we did a Marvel Madness tournament.
Legit feels on Street Fighter 5 Season 1.
It was different.
It was.
Definitely wasn't 4.
It also
what's with everyone in the diplomatic answers?
It's because Capcom might listen to this.
I didn't have as much fun as I'd expect of it. Like, I was expecting 5, you know, it's 5. Because I was expecting it to be the same sort of fucking high that I had when I first played 4, and then the game just, you know, I don't know, I don't like the OK game, I don't like the Okazemi in the game, I don't like the wake up options in the game, I don't like how you seem to be, you know, really down when you're on the ground. Meanwhile, in 4, it was like everyone had options, so you had to play a bit more smarter as the aggressor. Meanwhile, now it's like, fuck, you're just absolutely panicking when you're on the ground. I don't like it. I don't like it, I'm like a turtle on my back, and I don't like it, and I just want to get back on the other side. Sure, you can the mothers track better than me, but I can't, because it's Street Fighter 5.
Maybe the great white hope that is Season 2 that comes out tomorrow, as of the state of podcast.
That comes out, maybe now?
Technically now.
Well, you know what is out now, for some reason? Yeah. Fucking Kilgore!
Kilgore is legit, like,
Kilgore before
good.
Akamai.
Just does so much damage when he's on fire. It's gorgeous, and all of his animations are amazing. Like, I'm in love. Like, I want Kilgore, like, right
so,
now.
To act as a counterpoint to the two curmudgeons, I actually really like Season 1. Mm. I actually, like, I know it's not as
Luke,
good as 4, but
daggers.
I genuinely enjoyed it. I think Zangief in 5 is more fun than in 4. He is worse than in 4. You're less likely to win, but I find he's more fun. I really liked the fact that there was a story mode. I don't mind the fact that I had to wait a couple months. It was free. Stop looking at me like that, Miles. I didn't glare at you.
It was still fucking terrible.
It was a great... It was... Were you wanting, like, War and Peace? Were you wanting something dramatic?
I was wanting...
You got a Street Fighter story! There were people fighting in streets. It was dumb. Zangief took a sword to the neck and went, "Nah, man, I don't care."
That was legit.
And shattered it by flexing. Charlie or Nash killed himself again for no reason. Didn't help.
I did.
It is nothing.
It is shit.
It is the
Nikali was so great as a fucking jobber. the red herring that he is.
He didn't do anything.
He really did nothing. It was great. I like almost all the voice acting in this game. I like Yuri's voice. I like Lita's voice. I even,
I'll kick your ass!
Even in the story mode, I like Laura's voice.
Boom!
No.
I do not care for your guys' misery and pessimism. Fuck off, the game is good.
But you can't deny that the story was fucking retarded.
Yeah, it was retarded. Well, that's great. Much like if I had a son that was retarded, I'd still love it. Even though it's retarded. I don't care.
Yes.
Retarded does not mean bad.
Love overcomes all barriers. CJ's face is the most amazing thing I have ever seen today.
Should also clarify, if I had a daughter and she was around, I would also love her as well.
Gender isn't relevant in this.
But let's face it, I'm never having kids because I'm never getting laid. Robert, your opinion on Street Fighter 5?
Well, I'd just like to say that Shelf Shrap was brought to you by generous funding from Gibbo, the number one source of positive Street Fighter news on Facebook. But yeah, I like Street Fighter 5 for all of its shit flaws, which are me. Everything that's wrong with Street Fighter 5 for me is just me. So that's fine. The game itself is great. I am a terrible 5 player. So, Season 2, I'm hoping that I will be a better 5 player, but I will probably be a decent KI player instead. But that's okay, I love the game, people enjoy it, and you know what? Shitting on it or fucking manically loving it, people are still playing it. Like, we're always getting folk turning up to tournaments for
Capcom's
it.
Capcom's still supporting
Capcom's
it.
Every Shadow Cross is our biggest game.
It is, legit, it's always our biggest game. Like, people
ask for new games, we put in new games, 5 still more popular.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And that's it, at the end of the day, fucking 5 works. But, it's,
I think
but
it should also
it's
be
gonna
said,
get there.
5 wasn't the only fighting game that came out this year.
Oh god.
Fucking shit, there wasn't too many.
Because Revelator was this year?
Yeah, Revelator, we got our first taste of an anime here with Revelator.
Miles continues to represent strongly and do well in all the tournaments.
continues being our best
Guilty
Gear player.
Because he loves Guilty Gear so much.
Mile.
Season 3
you
was
legit
fucking
are.
Awesome.
No, I don't know how. Well, I know how, but I don't know why.
King of Fighters came out, and that was a thing.
We played that.
We did one tournament for it, and then regretted that because it took forever.
It's because it wasn't KI or Street Fighter.
Yeah.
And
KI
it did take
three.
A really long time. KI Season 3 is...
KI was worth the wait.
So,
CG's new main came in Season 3, Tusk.
Yeah.
And he got a wee big chubby for that glorious muscle-bound beardy bastard.
Act as a counter,
who is Robert?
As
I mean,
a counterpoint to me earlier. I think Season 3 has been the worst season for KI.
Seriously? How so?
Like, none of the characters have really, like, grabbed me.
I don't know, I've seen Gargos grab you before.
True, true.
Oh, yay, Gargos.
True. Still the person with the best record against it. Fuck CD. But, I don't know what, like, maybe it was just all the guest characters, but I found myself, like,
Season 1,
I stuck with Sidira. Season 2, I got picked up Hisako, and my still main Sidira.
Yep.
And then 3 made me focus more on Hisako. I had Mira, but I found myself more of the character balance changes being more of an effect than the new characters. Like, I know, like, there's Rash for Xander, Arbiter for Miles, Tusk for CG. Like, everyone had their characters, but just, for me, none of them jumped out. But, like, that being said, still love it. Still like KI more than Street Fighter V. Although I said good things about Street Fighter V and bad things about Season 3, KI as a whole is a much better game than Street Fighter V. But I've paid significantly more money to KI because I've paid for that game 3 times.
Yeah,
each season you pay again.
Yeah, but no, I was thinking about that today, right? Street Fighter's fucking Season 2, Season 5.
It's cheaper than...
It's 25 quid, right?
Oh, okay.
But when KI seasons come out, there are 16 quid for the characters or 30 quid for the characters and, like, extra stuff. Mm-hmm. If you just want the characters, it's, like, 16 quid. But Street Fighters come in and went, you want, what, 6 characters? That'll be, like, 25 quid. You might get a stage, you might not. You'll probably have to pay for it.
But you do get all their...
costumes.
Yeah, you get the costumes and the colours.
That's
what you get with the extra money, like the £30 for.
Aye, I suppose. I was thinking about just as characters, I suppose. So.
And there is the fight money aspect. Like,
yeah,
as much as it's not as good as we thought it was going to be, it's still viable. No, it's 50 for a game on right now. You get more for a win, and challenges will. Like, and if you do the challenges every time they reset, you'll build up money. Yeah, and weekends you get double fight money.
Ah, I should probably work on winning.
It wasn't just told me by a gremlin from off camera.
Our favourite Kilgore tester just now.
Robert, you're like everyone else's thoughts about season 3.
I'm mixed on it because I was really excited for the Arbiter, massive Halo fan, so I was like, oh, God, Jimmy the Arbiter's dashing about the place. But in practice, no one has been good enough to pull me away from Agonos, which is really weird because Agonos is technically a bit shit, or at least in my hands anyway. But I just love him. He's KI
for me. You do more with him than you have any right to.
Yeah, it's ridiculous because I don't even play him in any way like it should. But that being said, I love the... Like, as much as I hate Gargos and Idol, or, like, shat on them when they first came out, like, they're ridiculous. Like, that is the kind of, like, here's the mental shit we're going throughout. And then they patched it, and then they patched it again, and they worked on it. And you know what? Gargos is a fairer fight now. Idol still annoys me because he just covers the screen in projectiles, but, you know, fucking...
I still think Idol better than Gargos. Gargos still... Mainly because wing flap in the air... just ruins Sidira.
Yeah.
Like, it's just, well, I'm not doing anything.
But yeah, definitely KI. I mean, for a little while there, I kind of felt like, I don't know if I've got the same passion for KI, like maybe it was waning, but as soon as we played it again, Shadow Crash, it was like slipping on a comfortable pair of shoes. I was like, right, I'm in this, I suddenly know everything, my footsies are a bit coming, they're still crap, but like I remember them again.
Like, if you were asked, you couldn't say the things you're doing, but as soon as the controller's in your hand, you can do them again.
Everything felt like I was home, which is really weird, because KI has been a big part of Turbo Tuesdays, and I really enjoy it. But we got the new patch today, none of our mains got affected, which is always awesome.
No, Orchid and Arbiter got changes?
They were bug fixes. Well, Arbiter...
No, Arbiter got fucking...
Yeah, Arbiter got raped. Yeah.
Arbiter got given fucking nerf bullets in his gun there.
Yeah.
He just fucking shoots me darts.
It's so bad.
Yeah, what happened was the mains of the top three from Shadow Crush, all of our three best players' mains, they didn't get touched.
Mine was alright. Robert, coming in last all the time, guy.
Coming last on Saturday?
No, I don't think so, but I probably could have.
Sorry, Xander, but no, there was a child there as well.
Wee Craig came in, and you know what? Craig did pretty well in Street Fighter. This birdie has potential, he just needs to sit and play, and we need to school him. But not in a weird sex way. That'd be weird, Danny.
No, we're not Ewan.
But aye, you know what? This is like, when I started this shit, like, it started off as like just an extra event at Min-Max, and it was like, oh, we should do this, and we left it to the owner to run stuff, and
that was a mistake.
It was a mistake. Like, it's for all of his skills and other things. Running fighting game stuff just didn't work. And when I started assumed control and started like making this, like took hold and actually started doing stuff, that's when like this year got better. We actually like it's a mix of the hard work everybody come in. CG's like hard work and
his experience,
experience and contacts in the FGC, like. Just literally knowing everybody in Scotland and being like, there's a scene here, guys. Come play games with us. I'm pretty sure like he's bankrupt from like paying people to come and turn up to events, so we feel good when turn up.
He's been morally bankrupt for years, so it makes
sense.
That's
true, but that's why he fits in with us, because we're all terrible people.
Except
for Mark. Yeah, Mark's only been like three times. We've not corrupted him yet. He's still got time.
Mark, what are your thoughts on Street Fighter Season 1 and KI Season 3? Good talk.
Season 1 was okay. My main gripes are just the shitty fucking menus that never work.
Yeah, there's just so many, like...
And the fact that half the cast is, like, relatively obsolete, especially the real characters.
There's just not... One thing that I found that really bothered me about Street Fighter compared to Killer Instinct was the lack of balancing over the year. Like, KI's really spoiled us in how often they'll listen to feedback and adjust things and patches.
And not only like do they regularly do it, like, their patch notes are possibly the like
they're concise. As weird as it is to say, it's
probably the best patch notes that they do, because here is everything that we have changed and why we have changed them and how that will affect things.
Yeah, so I mean, fighting games, brilliant. That's pretty much it.
Anyone play any non-fighting games this year?
Hell of a lot of
game
Pokemon.
Of 2016, I'd say it's fucking Doom.
Oh my
Doom,
god,
Doom is the best
Doom.
Fucking game this
Doom,
year.
Like, for me, it's Doom or Overwatch. Depending on
is it Overwatch or buying loads of fucking crates? Watch. What do you prefer?
Well, crate watch. Loot crate.
I'm a whale.
You are a whale.
I have too much money.
Game of the Witcher year.
Loot watch.
Ooh, Witcher, Witcher 3.
I thought Witcher 3 came out last year in November.
Ah, but that DLC was big enough to be a
true.
Game.
True. Yeah.
Yeah, both the DLCs were massive.
CJ.
Whispers of the Old Gods.
Whispers of the Old Gods.
Hearthstone.
That's the Hearthstone expansion.
Ah, fuck it, man.
Also, just gonna say The Last Guardian as well. I've not beat it yet.
No,
the games
no, not whisper, not
Pokemon, mostly because it's a good
no,
devil Pokemon game, but
thrall.
Doom.
No, I'm thrall.
Just, you know, I play so many games, it's actually ridiculous.
I'm
I should
thrall,
not
now.
Play as many games as I do.
Okay,
but I have an incredibly
so,
understanding
actually played this
so I was thinking of games that I've played this year, and I remembered that at the start of the year I bought Quantum Break, and I started laughing.
Oh yeah,
Mario 3.
I was thinking.
Mario 3.
Tune in next week when we just play the fuck out of Mario 3. And I'm not even kidding. We're legit having like a retro party to celebrate at the end of the year. So,
you guys should
so
come
on down.
Yes, come down. Play all sorts of bitching ass old games
get
and tons of great fighting games because we'll actually have season 2 for Street Fighter by then.
And probably have the next KI character.
So is it safe to say that we're all more like excited for season 2 than we were for season 1? just from the patch, the character changes. I'm at least happier.
It's so extreme the changes that were done that it's gonna feel like a new game, or hopefully
yeah.
It'll feel like a new game.
Hopefully.
And we've got Akuma. We have like.
And we have Akuma.
We have a lion now.
Finally, we have Akuma.
Yeah,
Akuma
he's totally
Matata.
Not gonna be bent on lunch.
But that's all gonna get swept aside.
Yes.
Come, hopefully March time.
So how long is it going to be till that gets swept aside?
The real Akuma!
Isn't that just four Akuma?
Yeah, the real Akuma!
That doesn't sound like Third Strike. That doesn't sound like Akuma in literally any other game other than four.
Marvel Infinite.
Yeah, I see. I never said. Oh yeah, dude.
Oh
fuck
yeah, yeah of course. No, the best game of 2016. Oh, Marvel vs. Capcom 3!
Ah,
yeah.
That port.
It's snuck in there at the end.
Craziest
why,
thing like that.
Why couldn't they have just changed the netcode though?
I don't know.
Because
that's
fucking
fine.
Assholes.
What they've done is they've sold it on the PS4 with a shit netcode, and then everybody's gonna have to rebuy it on Xbox or Steam, so they get a good netcode. And then they'll be like, my fucking Capcom are like, ha ha ha, you bought it twice, you fucking mongs!
Twice? I'll buy it probably 6 times by the time it's 7.
Do you need a copy of fucking Marvel vs. Capcom 3? CJ will buy it.
No,
he won't. I don't know. He might
just,
ask
just
him.
Built a throne out of boxes.
Boxes of digital
you
copies.
You can have my 360
that's
copy.
That's why Ultimate was hard to find.
Redundant. Oh, and now Shelf has begun handing out Christmas presents because Shelf is like some weird like
nice person
nice
occasionally.
Wahey! Sweet, I think it might literally just turned up today.
That showed up a couple days ago.
Soon. Yes.
I think it showed up Sunday. Bizarrely enough.
Yes.
Ooh. Nice.
You don't have the webcam on, so they don't
see
the
real MVP here.
Aye, so Shelf being the real MVP that he is.
I like Christmas.
He just picked me up a brute Xbox One to PS4 adapter, so now I'll stop bitching about the PS4. But
which is weird because I think everyone else agrees it's a better controller than the Xbox One.
I just don't like it.
See what CG has.
What does CG have?
CG has the only,
got
gift,
an arm,
the only gift that was wrapped. This was the only gift that was ordered off Amazon.
Oh.
What is it?
Big Apple Takedown.
Big Apple Takedown.
A WWE novel with Tori Wilson on the cover.
Do you want to read the blurb?
Big Apple Takedown, December 2001. Vince McMahon steps out of a snowy night into a diner in upstate New York for a meeting with old friend Phil Thompson. Now a highly placed government official, Thompson has a strange proposition. Creating a new covert Black Ops group using the superstars of World Wrestling Entertainment.
Oh my god.
The WWE's talented men and women are perfect. Highly skilled athletes with the ideal cover. They travel all across the country and the globe. No one will find it unusual to find them in the town one day and gone the next. The government would train and support the wrestlers in any way possible except one. No one can know the truth.
What? A WWE spy novel?
Yeah!
Holy
fast
shit.
Fast forward to March 2006, the superstars will be handed their latest assignment. Take down a commercial-grade methamphetamine plant that is bankrolling terrorist activities in Europe. Their mission seems simple and straightforward until a member of their team is taken prisoner.
Is this wrestling?
Now that they've worked so hard, now all they've worked so hard for is in jeopardy. And one of their own might be killed.
Holy shit! Yeah.
So that you actually sent me why as soon as I saw that, I had to get you.
Yes! So anyway, Tori Wilson's on the cover looking banging with her tits out.
And a gun.
Which is always good. And on the back is some really bad black and white photographs of John Cena, Batista, Booker T, Vince McMahon, who's clearly a different background from them all, and Triple H.
That is
and
amazing.
I can imagine that maybe that is the spy team of John Cena, Batista, Booker T, and Triple H. And I can imagine that the operative that gets captured will be Booker T.
Yeah. Now, because I ordered off Amazon and got it wrapped, I haven't had a chance to read it either. So I see, whenever you're doing a stream or something, CJ, and things start just get the book out and just start reading. Lighten up your Hearthstone stream.
Aye, next time you got Hearthstone stream, waiting on the next opponent, just bang out a chapter.
Bang out a chapter.
I'll fucking start watching your Hearthstone if you read that.
Pocketbook.
I thought I said pop-out book, like
pop-out book. Big Apple takes it.
Right.
And although he's not here, he had to leave early, Kyle also got a Christmas gift.
It was the best.
I threw a bag of salt at him.
He fucking legitimately threw a kilo of salt at him.
A kilo and a half.
A kilo and a half. Didn't you say you actually got something though?
Yeah, I did actually get him a gift, but I didn't arrive in time.
Ah, well.
I blame the incompetent people who work at Amazon. Probably the ones in the shipping dock, those who load for Royal Mail.
Yeah, yeah, those guys.
Those guys.
So, Miles, what did you
get?
That's
me, guys. That's what I do.
Miles has a thing.
Yeah, Chef got me Sonic and Mega Man Worlds Collide. That's a fucking
And don't worry. Don't worry. Vector is in there, so you can get as much time in your wicker chain as you want.
Fucking hell.
I respect that.
See, this is still, I still feel bad though, because CG got a clearly shit gift.
No, I'll tell you when I read it.
And everyone else got actual gifts.
What was that?
I'm rocking the fucking Kilgore
over there.
Thanks, man.
Thanks.
Don't throw it at him, because you'll break my stuff.
It's a card.
Alright.
I was genuinely surprised he caught it.
Fucking
he just caught it with even fucking stuffing. He's like, nah, fuck it. Alright, so.
There's a gift card in there.
Ah, nice.
All members of the family are getting gift cards.
Oh, he's a member of the family now.
He's dating my cousin.
That's right.
We have. There's an envelope in front of him.
What is his miniguns?
Yes, his miniguns. What about his miniguns?
Yeah, effects.
Now they're speeding up and he does more hits with his gun attacks.
What did you do to speed them up?
Heavy DP.
Oh shit! So you're right, that heavy DP got those guns spinning.
Yes, and now he does 8 hits with just heavy punch.
Right, Tom Jenkins in KIUK is asking, how do we play him as it says available in 13 hours on his game? Did we have a timer for Kilgore?
No, because we're not online.
Yeah,
we're not online. We're not online just now. The glitch.
Yeah, we can fight him, but we can't use him unless he's in training. Unless he's player two in training.
If you listen to our podcast, you'll get the explanation.
By the time you upload this, it'll be out.
Yeah, because I keep forgetting I'm recording it way too high quality.
Man, I'm so excited for Kilgore, you guys.
Kilgore instinct.
Right.
Oh, fuck, that works.
So yeah, is anybody...
What was that look for? that look is for Tori Wilson.
He's having a great time with that excellent
the
rapping.
The best diva with the least skill.
Right, so has anybody else got anything else they want to talk about? Because, you know, we've got a bit of time.
Worst game
minutes.
Of this year?
I can't think of the worst. Miles, I can name a game right now that you'll agree with me is a worst disappointment.
I think I know which one.
And that is Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
I was going to say Mighty Number 9.
Disappointment.
Wait, Ninja Turtles by Platinum or Mighty Number 9 or Street Fighter 5? Biggest disappointment.
ReCore!
Wow!
ReCore was good up until the last dungeon. Where it just fucking stops you dead. No, you're not allowed to play anymore.
Final Fantasy 15.
Shut up. Piece of shit. I like my beautiful boys. And you know you like your beautiful boys. That's what you said in your review. Your
not,
beautiful boys
I'm
in a
car. Not Jim Sterling.
You say that, but I've never seen you and Jim Sterling in the same room. How come you're never there when I'm watching Jim Sterling show, eh?
CG.
How come you're never there?
CG, either you're Jim Sterling or you're one-man gang.
One-man gang.
Yeah, I got glasses and dyes hair black. He's definitely Jim Sterling.
Thank God. To be fair, this all wouldn't be happening without me. So really, you should all be thanking God for me.
That's true. I do. I go home and I'm like, you know, when I'm beating off to that picture of you that I got when you weren't looking, I'm just like, yeah.
He is born different.
He is born. Oh, CJ, you're probably a hero to somebody.
Ceiling. A nice ceiling poster of CG on the wall.
No, because I'm married. How would I pass that? But I'm still like, Robert, why is there a big picture of CG up on the wall? Well, wife, it's because I masturbate to it when you're not here. Well, Robert.
That was the only wall space we have left.
Aye, all the rest of them are covered by pictures of Mark. Look, man, I've got weird tastes. That's all I'm saying. Anyway, look, I'm fucking spinning wheels now. Is anybody else going?
We're now out of things to say.
Spinning guns.
Kilgore has an OTG.
Kilgore has an OTG.
Do it again.
Do it again.
Kilgore has an OTG.
Do it off a sweep. Prove that it is an OTG.
Oh, shit.
Sweep.
Sweep.
Sweep and do it.
Fucking mess.
You can sweep a dead
He's
body.
Dead.
Apparently we have OTG tech for Kilgore.
That picks up!
Whoa!
See, he's thrown away the gift.
Cancel it into something. That fucking DP so try hard.
Nope. What about the ball? Does the ball not recapture?
No, I tried.
So, shadow DP, since that doesn't move you forward?
Missiles.
It's a couple missiles. Hidden missiles! Beep, 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 beep.
They'll come.
Not everything's Markle. What is it, Mark? Michael, even?
Markle.
Aye, Markle. I may have stole your Fanta to drink.
Got old Markle's
the host. Ah, so that's who the Fanta was.
Yes, we finally solved the mystery of the Fanta.
Anyway, I'm not going to drink all anyway, so.
No worries, man.
I think I'm probably going to get going.
That's cool. We're about to wrap up the podcast anyway, so.
Got anyone to shout out on it? Shout
yeah,
people
yeah.
out.
Tell if you've got anything coming up. If you've got anybody's got anything to talk about, I've got nothing.
Look forward to Masters of Unlocking coming soon.
Fuck off! I'll get to it when I get to it.
Can't wait for Masters of Unlocking.
Piss off it. Get in my face. I'll fix it when I want.
Well, I'll be at other conventions next year. Hopefully one at Paisley and another one at Inverness. Hopefully.
Excellent. I've been up to a few conventions in Inverness. It's a nice meet
hopefully gets there in Masters of Unlocking.
No, it's on the last bit. I just need to fucking get the last key and fight Boskunovic.
We've got the last key.
No, I'm sure we've not got the last key. You say that, but I'm pretty sure we don't.
You need to play
check
through.
The footage.
I'll
put the footage through. On the stream.
Fuck off, I'm not putting footage
you
anyway.
You play through it one more time after you've got all the keys.
Aye, that's what I'm saying. I think I don't have all the keys. Anyway, right, I'm having enough of this. The guys stop berating me about Masters Unlocking. I'll eventually
Bye.
Get round to it. Bye, everybody.
Merry Christmas.
Bye.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.